In this lecture, we'll talk about separable polynomials and separable extensions following section 13.5 of Dummett and Foote. And in this first video, what I want to do is give the main definitions and state the main results that we'll prove in this lecture. Let's say f is a field and f of x is a polynomial in f bracket x. This polynomial is separable if it has distinct roots in a splitting field for f of x over f. So we know that all the splitting fields for f of x over f are isomorphic to each other. So it's not difficult to see that if you have distinct roots in one splitting field, then in fact, you have distinct roots in every splitting field. Okay, well, in a splitting field, f of x factors as a product of linear factors. So those linear factors give you the roots, and the powers of the linear factors give you the multiplicities of those roots. So what separable means is that each root of f of x in a splitting field has multiplicity 1. All right, well, if f of x has a multiple root in a splitting field, that is, f of x is not separable, then f of x is called inseparable. I want to give some very straightforward examples, some easy examples. If you take f of x to be x squared minus 2 in q bracket x, this is separable. Why? Well, one splitting field for this polynomial over q is q adjoined square root of 2, where we have these roots plus or minus square root of 2. And these roots are distinct in q adjoined square root of 2. So it has distinct roots in a splitting field, so it is separable. What if you take a power of a polynomial like x squared minus 2 to the n? Well, that's in q bracket x. That's inseparable for any n at least 2, because in a splitting field, for example, q adjoined square root of 2, you have these two roots, plus or minus square root of 2, and each root will have multiplicity n. A lot of what's interesting that will happen with separable polynomials and separable extensions will happen over fields of characteristic p. So let's look at an example, x cubed minus 2 in f3 bracket x. This polynomial is inseparable. Why? Because it factors in f3 bracket x as x plus 1 cubed. So minus 1 is a root of this polynomial of multiplicity 3. All right, so we'll go from separable polynomials to separable elements. Let's say that alpha is algebraic over f. It is separable over f if the minimal polynomial of alpha over f is separable. Okay, so we can talk about whether or not an element alpha that's algebraic is separable. That's just, is the minimal polynomial separable? So we won't talk about whether or not an element that's not algebraic is separable. So this is just a description that we can apply to algebraic elements over F. Okay, so what does this mean? That the minimal polynomial has distinct roots in a splitting field for this polynomial over F. And if alpha is not separable, that is, if the minimal polynomial of alpha is inseparable, then alpha is called inseparable, or inseparable over f. So, okay, just as a quick example, square root of 2 is an element that's algebraic over q. The minimal polynomial, x squared minus 2, is separable. So square root of 2 is separable over q. All right, so what does it mean for a field extension to be separable? So the field K is separable over F if the extension K over F is algebraic and every alpha in K is separable over F. Okay, so we know that every element in this extension K of F is algebraic over F. And we can ask for these algebraic elements, are they separable or not separable? So separable means every alpha is separable over F. Okay, well, what if it's not a separable extension? We're only going to talk about whether or not an algebraic extension is separable or not separable. So I don't want to talk about extensions that are not algebraic. An algebraic extension K over F is inseparable if at least one alpha in K is inseparable over F. Okay, so what have we defined? We've defined what it means for a polynomial in f bracket x to be separable or inseparable. We've defined what it means for an element that's algebraic over f to be separable or inseparable. This is just asking, is the minimal polynomial separable or inseparable. And then we've defined what it means for an algebraic field extension to be separable or inseparable. All right, so I'm going to pause and erase. I'll say a little bit more about this issue of field extensions being separable or inseparable, and then I'll state the main thing that we'll prove in this lecture. I want to say a little more about this condition of an algebraic field extension K over F being inseparable. So if K over F is inseparable, it does not mean that every alpha in K is inseparable over F. All it means is that there is some alpha in K that is inseparable over F, so that it's not the case that every alpha in K is separable over F. So this is easy to get confused about at first. This is like the condition that G is a non-abelian group. This does not mean that for every pair X and Y and G, XY is not equal to YX. It just means that there is some pair X and Y and G where XY is not equal to YX. Okay, so now that we understand what it means for a polynomial to be separable, for an element to be separable, for an extension to be separable, I can state the main thing that we'll prove in this lecture. I'll call this corollary 39 prime because it's actually, this is part of corollary 39, but we're going to prove something even a little bit better. We're first going to show that every finite extension of a field of characteristic zero is separable. We're then going to show that every finite extension of a finite field is separable. So what do we know? Finite extensions we know are algebraic. So the question is just, every finite extension of a field of characteristic zero is algebraic. Is it the case that for every element in that extension, the minimal polynomial is always separable? We'll show that the answer is yes. Same kind of question for a finite field. If you have a finite extension of a finite field, it's algebraic. The question is every element in that field extension separable over your original finite field? And what is that asking? For every element, you have a minimal polynomial, which is a monic irreducible polynomial. And we want to know if those minimal polynomials are always separable. So the big thing that we're going to talk about in order to get to this result is, okay, well, when are polynomials separable in general, but more specifically, when are irreducible monic polynomials separable?